Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji. In the last few videos, we created walls, floors, roofs, and so on. In this video, we're going to make it even more parametric, so everything is going to be controlled through Dynamo. So for now, you see if I run this and then go to my Revit, you notice that the roofs do not have the correct base offset from the level. And in the last video, I adjusted that in Revit. This time I'm going to adjust it in Dynamo itself. So I want this to be moved by negative 70 centimeters, negative 0.7 down, so it's going to be exactly on top of the wall. Let's see, if I go here, this part is responsible for creating my roofs. I'm going to show you something new. If you go to Revit, Elements, under Element again, there are a couple of very interesting items. One of them is set parameter by name. Or you can right click on the canvas, type set parameter, and it's gonna show. So a roof is an element. We know that because roofs under the Elements tab. So that is quite okay if I connect roof to the element. The parameter that I want to set is the base offset from level. And it's going to accept one string node. I'm going to right click, type a string. I'm going to bring a string node to the canvas. And here is the tricky part. If you want to set a parameter, it should have the exact same spelling as it's here, right? So notice we have base offset from level, right? And B, O, F, and L are capital letters. That's very important. I'm going to come here, type base offset from level. I'm going to assign it over there, and the value is going to be negative 0.7, which is total thickness of the floor and the roof. So I'm going to assign negative 0.7, and I know this is in meters because Revit is in meters. Assign it over there. Now let's say before I run it, let's say if I accidentally do not put a capital F here, let's see what happens. I'm gonna run this and this becomes orange. It says no parameter found by that name. So it's kind of sensitive to even how you choose the letter. So I'm gonna go with capital F. I'm gonna run this and it works correctly. If I come back here, all the roofs that I have in the file have an offset of negative 0.7, and all of them are exactly where they should be. Okay, so let's come back here. This is also about roofs. So how about I create a group here? I want to go with the same color that I've been using for the roofs, and I want to mention that this is setting my roofs base offset. Okay. So now it's one level more parametric because now also the offsets are created here. So if I change something, let's say if I go and change the rotation of the floors from 3 degrees to like 5 degrees, if I run it and go back to my file here, everything is automatically adjusted, base offset and everything are correct. Okay. Now, I want to make it a little bit more parametric, right? Let's say here. Another thing that we manually assigned was the number to actually for the top offset of the wall or for the height of the wall, we decreased 0.7 from the height of the level, which was 3.8, because that's the thickness of the roof plus floor. Now, what if I change the type of the floor that I have in Revit? Let's say, for instance, I go here, I want to select one of the floors. I'll go to edit type. I need to create one so it's going to show in my Dynamo. So I'm going to create one floor which is 300 millimeters. Okay. Let's go to edit, change this to 0.3. Let's say okay. I'm going to copy the exact same name. Okay. All right. So Now if I come here, go back to Dynamo, and if I select the new floor, which is 300 instead of 400, and run this, if I go back to my Revit, now all my floors are 300, and let me show you here. You see there is a little gap between the two, because in Dynamo we assign 0.7, but now that these two numbers, the thickness of the floor and the roof, add up to 0.6 meters, it's not going to work correctly. So I need to find a way to also assign this number as a parameter, so it's going to update automatically. So this is how we can do that. Let me move this over there. Under Revit, under elements again, the same location that we had set parameter by name, we also have get parameter value by name. So here's what I want to do. I want to get the thickness of the floors, I want to get the thickness of the roofs, I want to add them together, and then I want to assign them to my y value here, so it's going to be absolutely parametric. In this case, my elements are floor. I want to get the parameter name, so floor goes there. Parameter name is thickness. How do I know? In Revit, if you select the floor, scroll down, this is thickness. So parameters come from the menu here and should have the same exact spelling. Thickness with a capital T. That goes to parameter name. And if I run this, that number should be 0.3, which is correct. I need this once again. And this time I want to get the thickness of the roof. That goes there. And if I run this, that also should be 3 because the thickness of the roof was 3. Good. So let me move this to here. And now I want to add these two. I can bring a code block. I want to say get parameter A plus parameter B. You can put anything like X plus Y. So this goes to A, this goes to B, and if I run this, this is going to show as 0.6. Now this is the value that I want to reduce from the height of the level. So this goes to my Y value over there. I can get rid of the code block. So this part here is for nodes are responsible to tell me how to adjust the wall height. So let me see this. I can group this. I want to go with the same color that I have for the wall. So this is going to be this orange color. This one actually. And this is going to be wall height decrease. This is how I adjust the height. Okay, that goes there, that goes there. So anything that we assigned as a separate value can be considered as a parameter. We can take a look to see if there is anything else that we are manually assigning. Yes, here. Now I also need to change that base offset because that should be the same value. So that code block that I created, that also goes to my value here. So if I change the type of the floors, the type of the roof, everything is gonna automatically adjust.